hey, it's Juliet.
Man, I should have done something. That guy was an asshole.
I don't get it. How could Zack and Victoria do that to me?
Hi, Juliet. How are you doing?
Oh, hey, Max. Sorry, I'm still screwed up.
Sorry you had to find out about Zachary that way. Or anyway.
Better sooner than later. Now that skank Victoria won't be laughing behind my back anymore.
Have you talked to Zack yet?
Mr. Badass Football Hero is such a chicken shit. He said he sexted Victoria as a joke. Ha ha. I think Warren wants your attention.
He usually does.
It's a joke because he has a tiny penis.
Hang in there, Juliet.
See you around, Max.
At least Rachel Amber has people who care about her.
Mm-hmm. Wait, did that say she had a tattoo on her calf of a dragon?
At least Rachel Amber has people who care about her.
Yeah. Cars equal death. SXFTN. I didn't even know what that's supposed to be. Bird church.
Now this really pisses me off. So entitled. Sorry, handicapped folks. My truck needs these two spots more than you do. Bastard.
Okay.
It's not a dirty window unless somebody writes clean me on it.
I know whose RV this is. I don't understand why it's currently parked outside Blackwell, though.
I could use this picture for a series on Arcadia Bay lots.
Max always has ideas. Never follows through with them.
A new surveillance system. That's how it starts.
Another red truck.
Come on over here, please.
Please.
Look at Warren in his Wayback Machine. He's a brave man.
Okay, I think that's all we need in the parking.
What up, Max? How are you?
Here's your flash. Thanks.
No problem. Check out my new wheels.
Cool.
Warren's
very
so adorable.
Old school.
1978, to be exact. Now we can go to the drive-in. There's one in Newburgh just 60 miles away.
You're in the wrong time, Warren. But then, so am I.
You okay?
It's been one strange fucking day.
I bet. I heard Victoria got a face full of paint. I'd pay money to see a photo of that.
Really? I wish I would have known.
You probably could have raised a Kickstarter fund just for that one image of her covered in paint.
Had I known that. Anyway, Victoria took down my photo, so that drama ended well.
By the way, I saw Daniel's sketch of you online. Not bad, but I could do a much better job.
Of drawing? I doubt it.
You can draw? I thought you were blinded by science, not art.
Art is science. Music is math, etc., etc. I'd put Stephen Hawking against Picasso any day.
Hardcore. So you must use a computer to draw?
Of course. I'd love to tweak one of your selfies with some cool graphics.
That might not suck. I'll let you know.
So, did you get a chance to check out the movie booty on my flash drive?
Yeah, thanks. You had some cool shit on there, from Akira to Twilight Zone, which seems apropos today.
I consider myself a pop cultural pirate connoisseur.
That does sound better than thief.
Ha ha. Make sure you watch Cannibal Holocaust.
Seen it. I was more disturbed by all those emo vampire movies in there.
Can a sensitive high school boy love sensitive vampires too?
Ew.
So you're sensitive.
Ouch, that sounds awful the way you say it.
No, I was impressed you had faster pussycat kill kill.
Russ Meyer was a genius of black and white. Plus, babes with breasts.
Who would beat your sensitive ass down?
If I was lucky. Speaking of hip Jesus. And fast, we should cruise out in my car to an actual movie this week. But you seem distracted.
I need to talk to somebody, just to get it out of my system.
Dr. Warren Graham is in the house. I won't even prescribe you any meds.
Jesus.
Tell me everything.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me, not social media.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
I had this incredibly bizarro experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caulfield, right? You're one of the Jefferson's photo groupies?
I'm one of his students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathrooms. You best tell me what you saw, now. Answer me,
what are you
bitch.
Talking about?
I know you're new here, but don't even play stupid with me.
I'm not new. I've lived here for years.
But I guess
then
not.
You should know the Prescotts own this shithole.
Then you don't have to worry about me. Worry about yourself.
Do not analyze me! I pay people for that. Worry about yourself, Max Caulfield.
Take a step back, Nathan Prescott.
Oh man, you're telling me what to do?
Get away from her, dude!
Hey! Leave him alone!
Nobody tells me what to do! Not my parents, not the principal,
that.
Or that whore
right
in the bathroom!
Jesus.
Max? Chloe?
No way. You again.
Warren!
No! No! I got this!
Get in, Max!
Get your punk asses out of there now! Don't even try to run! Nobody! Nobody!
Jeez. David showed up to watch Nathan beating the crap out of
him. Man,
Nathan
Warren, Prescott is messed
and nothing's
up.
Gonna happen.
And dangerous. This day never ends.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe. After 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield. Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I am seriously glad to see you. Oh, and thanks, Chloe. It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
Hopefully nothing after today. So, how do you know Nathan?
He's just another Arcadia asshole. Your friend really took a beat down for you.
Warren? Yeah, I owe him big time.
You're not the only one in debt, and you're already causing trouble.
I thought it would be quiet here. Feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
Pretty much.
I guess. It was cool, but I felt kind of lonely, out of my league.
I would think you'd fit right in with the art school hipsters.
Right. You look like the cover of hipstergirl.com.
At least you're still a smartass.
Of
That's
course.
That's why I'm here.
Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
Of course. It's one of the best photography programs in the country. And my favorite teacher, Mark Jefferson.
So you came back to Arcadia for a teacher, not your best friend.
Don't you think I'm happy to see you?
No. You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
I'm sorry. I know things were tough on you when I left.
How do you know? You weren't even here.
I didn't order my parents to move specifically to fuck you over, Chloe.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
I just wanted to settle in first and not be such a shy, cliche geek. I totally would have contacted you.
I bet you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me, Max.
I do use them on Mr. Jefferson. only she knew we saved her life earlier.
Broken? Man, are you serial?
Wow, haven't heard that one in a while.
Not everything changes. Except my camera has officially taken a shit.
My step douche has a boatload of tools. Maybe you can fix it in my place.
I need very specific tiny tools.
Nerd alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage, and he actually is a tiny tool. Welcome home, Max.
She has one of the Illuminati triangles in her car, too.
Come on in, don't be shy.
The house still looks nice.
Home, shit, home.
And of course it would have an American flag hanging outside.
My room looks a bit different than the last time you saw it.
It's cool. At least we can chill out.
This isn't exactly my chill-out zone. My step-fuhrer makes sure of that. Come in and close the door. Put on some music while I medicate.
Okay, let's start snooping.
This postcard is from Rachel Ember. We had such a blast drawing these together.
Cosmic snail.
And it reeks like dirty laundry. Gross.
Dude, you broke my glass snow dough. Thanks.
Something I could do to make it so it wouldn't fall.
Old cardboard boxes. Chloe totally changed her style. I barely recognized her. Chloe was always taller than me. We made her dad keep track of her height.
Another American flag.
Nothing but junk in this suitcase.
She does not hide that she's... I mean, isn't she about her age?
So tell me, what does Max Caulfield do for fun now that she's a grown-up?
I don't feel grown-up, just more confused as I get older. Especially after today.
Gee, thanks. I was hoping to hear something positive.
About me?
No, about me. Duh. I thought you'd at least be happy taking photos. Forget it.
I've never seen this before.
So tell me, what does Max...
I take photos. Of me, the world, everything. It may sound sad, but I have a blast.
It doesn't sound that sad.
I'm happiest when I've got a great image in my lens. I'm not lonely, not afraid.
Now that's more inspiring. I don't feel so totally hopeless. Hey, give me that!
Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy. Obviously, she was a good friend.
You were kind of trying to be nosy.
Putting it mildly.
That's Rachel Ember. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
Yeah, I put them up.
She was my angel. After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Man, I had no idea.
Well, you never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
I never forgot, even if I was an asshole and didn't keep in touch. But you had Rachel.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
I see why. I bet your mom was not too happy.
She was happy enough to marry a Nazi. Reason number 356 to escape.
I feel the love.
I'd love to hear the other 355.
Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago. She just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
What about her parents? Are they looking for her?
They're in denial. Max, I know she's missing.
I assume you know more than that.
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. Then poof.
And you haven't heard anything from her since?
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel. Gone. Can you put on some music now?
Who'd have thunk Chloe wouldn't pay her parking tickets? She does love trouble.
One of these is actually relevant for the next episode. I think. Maybe not.
We used to dare each other to climb down, but never did. So it was Chloe who printed all those flyers. Is this a desk or a storage space?
Why not both?
She looks super happy. She looks super sad. She looks super stoned.
Jesus. How original, Max.
Hey, that TV used to be in the living room. Look at that. Chloe and her dad were so close.
No, they can't.
Damn, Chloe does need a lot of money to get out of Arcadia.
Gee, wow. The music is far too peaceful in this game.
Anyway, you can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment. Snowdo. Thanks.
Damn. Chloe was kicked out of Blackwell 2 years ago. She used to be a great student. When she cared.
Okay, let's go get some tools.
You tell me stories of
whoa, dark. I cannot see anything. This is definitely Joyce's makeup. Chloe wouldn't use animal products. hope Chloe isn't taking these pills.
Is it the one where I looked up and it was an antidepressant?
I like Chloe's new hair color. She's the opposite of shy. Of me.
Let's be courteous and turn off the light.
You can't go home again, said Thomas Wolfe. But here I am. This must be Chloe's parents' room. Man, I am nosy today.
We should save the bird.
Act, React, or Die, a 21st Century Survival Guide. Whoa, apocalypse self-help. Dog tags, sweet.
David and Madsen.
David Madsen.
And now we know who Step Douche is. Let's actually leave the window open so the birdie can leave. I'm singing songs
about the future. Oh my. Chloe made this for Joyce on Mother's Day years ago. I see why she would keep it. Joyce still works at the diner. Is her husband a cop? Poor Chloe.
Ah, Max, you're sometimes just oblivious.
Uh-oh. The prices are late on their bills.
Yikes. Family is just all kinds of money problems.
Joyce looks happy. Chloe's stepdad might not be a douchebag after all.
But Chloe looks miserable.
You've been resurrected, birdie. Fly, be free.
Don't worry, I'm just screwing with
Joyce always
chaos.
Loved her mail order catalogs of useless crap.
Now every bird that bird come, or everything that bird comes into contact with will disrupt
Joyce has a
time.
Little shrine to William. Her new husband may not be such a douche.
Okay, I think that's all in this room.